Yo, check it. Catch me on No Rink On Show in another 20 minutes, half an hour. BBC Asian Network, live. Bless.
AJD on the BBC Asian Network. And as mentioned, Dr. Zeus will be in the studio chatting to us. A guy who needs no introduction. Obviously, his hits across the years and his dynamic range of changing styles in terms of his music and the people that he's worked with speaks for itself. It really, really does. And I'll be speaking to Zeus all about it, including his brand new track as well. So it only accounts that, you know, of course, I should be playing one of Zeus's evergreen hits. And of course, he's got quite many, especially with a lot of the people that he's brought to the forefront as well. He's worked with the likes of Jazz Dummy, Kanika Kapoor, and a lot more as well. This one's going back to one of his standout albums, I would say, one that definitely put him on the map in the UK and all over the world. It was from Under the Influence, a track which, again, had so many flavours and different ranges in regards to what it had on there. I'll speak a bit more about it once I've played the song and once Zeus is in the studio as well. But for now, just listen to the intro. You know what song it is. No real introduction, really. It is Kangana, Dr. Zeus, and Master Rakesh. No doubt, you the book now. You got everything. You got everything. Hold up. What a good way to begin. No doubt, you the book now. You got everything. You got everything. Hold up. What a good way to begin. कंगना तेरा नी सानू करिए यार कंगना तेरा नी सानू करिए यार Well, we know that the doctor likes to work on his own time, of course. So it's only right that we got him in the studio right about now. Dr. Zeus in the studio.
Yo, 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 I'm so sorry I'm late, man. Birmingham traffic, man. Birmingham traffic.
Birmingham traffic is where it's at, man. So Zeus, obviously, like I mentioned, it is, you know, you got here a little bit late, but it's fine. We're going to be covering all about your brand new single that's just come out as well.
Yeah, man, we literally got 7 minutes to do that, yeah?
I think even less than 7 minutes, but it's fine. One thing I wanted to mention, obviously, it's quite a bit of a contrast change in regards to Global Injection, so your last album. So yeah, in that sense, you've kind of shifted the dynamics and gone onto TikTok, man. So tell us all about it.
TikTok, I mean, it's something that I always wanted to do. You know, I always like different challenges and stuff.
Yeah.
And TikTok's a different challenge to me. It's like an English song.
Yeah.
For one, the language is different.
Yeah.
And I want to appeal out to more than just Indian fan base, you know, because I feel as though my music can kind of cut across, you know.
Definitely.
So it's kind of like just an experimental project at the same time, you know.
Yeah.
But it's getting mad feedback, man, you know. So I can say when we're kind of sitting on a million views at the moment, you know what I mean? And organically, it's like, you know, and it's mad because, you know, I have an Indian fan base.
Yeah.
Right. And this is an English song.
Yeah.
So, I mean, I don't know. either the Indian fan base are taking to the English song nicely, or either I'm getting a new set of fan base, I don't know, but those numbers are coming.
I was going to say as well, I was listening, obviously I've watched the video and listened to the track as well, it's very UK-esque, you've gone for that vibe as well as that, the vocalist as well. So shifting, the, obviously, you're the master of kind of like ranging your style and shifting the dynamics. How is it coming towards, you know, switching towards that kind of like UK-esque vibe?
For me, it's very easy because, like, I'll be honest with you, I've always been into being like experimenting and stuff. It's just the usual, you know, in the Indian industry, people just want to follow and kind of thing, you know. And I'm kind of very much like, you know, when I did Kangana, even, you know, it was experimental for me. So I'm always looking to do experimental projects. So it was easy for me because Amber, the vocalist on there, she's only 15, and I was blown away with how talented she is.
Wow.
You know, when she came into my studio, and she has a uniqueness.
Yeah.
At what she brought. Right, and then it was those two things combined together, and then we got like K Dotty,
yeah,
my homie, you know, like she's just like dangerous when it comes to like, you know, the urban flavor and stuff, you know. And she has amazing songs coming with me in the future, and
brilliant.
Same with Amber, you know. So this is just a start. I want to be doing what I wanted to be doing in an ideal world is parallel be doing Punjabi songs, Hindi songs and whatever, and doing the Bollywood stuff, and doing something like doing English songs and trying to make my sound kind of cut across. I'm trying to like prove a point that, listen, music is like a universal language. If people in India could be listening to Despacito and don't understand a word, why cannot we have a Punjabi dude or a Punjabi song in a UK market or something? I mean, even though this song is English, right, but I'm kind of working towards them ways, you know what I mean?
You've got that following and you've got that fan base. You've got every right to be able to do that as well, Zeus, man. So you know what? Right behind you in that sense as well. Also, just a quick one, just before we have to probably wrap up. I've seen the writers on the track, yeah?
Yeah.
So obviously, Amber and K Dotty are the writers, and then there's Baljeet as well.
Yeah.
So that's me. So you've helped out out there as well, yeah?
No. I mean, when it comes to writing, I think writing is classed, you know, when you do, when you publish a song, like kind of an English song, writing is perceived in a way, you know, like I'm a writer because I wrote music, and then Amber's a writer because she wrote the lyrics, and also K Dotty because she wrote a little rap words and her melodies there. So we're all three of us are writers.
Yeah, man, wicked,
you know.
Wicked.
And it has to be documented in real names and stuff. You know.
Oh yeah, of course. Yeah, so, for the back end work. Yeah.
Yeah, for the back end work. You know.
Of course, man. Okay, so just to wrap up in regards to Amber T and K Dotty as well, working with yourself, they are kind of long term projects for yourself.
Yeah, definitely. You're gonna see a lot more stuff coming from Amber T because she's talented beyond belief.
Yeah.
And same goes with my home girl, K Dotty. Okay. She's got some dangerous tunes, trust me.
Wicked, man. Zeus, it was short and sweet.
I'm so sorry. I have to apologize to all the listeners. It's my fault. We cannot blame the BBC Asian Network.
I always see Zeus out on the road, always smashing those decks up as well, man. So it's nice to have that little bit of a change.
Yeah, man.
Yo, Zeus, we're going to drop a little quick snippet of your song. Do you want to just introduce it for everyone?
Yeah, man. This is my new single, TikTok, featuring Amber T and K Dotty.
Yes, sir.
Got some things to confess, but I don't wanna waste any time now, baby. Cause you've been on my mind, that's all I've been thinking about yet lately. So come and take a ride with me and see where this thing goes. Cause I don't wanna wait, I don't wanna wait, I don't wanna wait, cause you know. TikTok, talk, tick. Just step and step out of my way. Trip, drop, drop. Start wasting my time when I'm playing no play. TikTok, talk, tick. Just step and step. Stop wasting my time when I'm playing no games.
Dr. Zeus, TikTok, Amber T and K Dotty. It's a pleasure. Yeah, make sure that you get it. It's available on all outlets as well. Make sure you stream it. Make sure you do whatever you want with it as well. You got to make sure you watch the video as well. It's a whole load of UK vibe happening on there.